There are two installation kits for manual logger, one for PCs and one for mobile devices. What this video covers is the Pi manual logger installation kit for PCs. As with all software, the manual should be consulted to make sure that prerequisites, install steps, and post-install steps are understood clearly. Two of the prerequisites for Pi manual logger are first installation of the OSI prerequisites kit and also the presence of SQL Server. Most versions of SQL Server are supported, including SQL Server Express. That's what I'll be using here today. Also, SQL Server does not have to reside on the same machine as manual logger, but in this case, I'll do that to show a simple case. There are actually two install paths for manual logger. One is installing manual logger to get the database, which resides in SQL Server, set up. The second case is just install manual logger on any PC that will be used for the manual logger data entry. We're really showing both these cases here today. Also, if you're planning to use PiML Web Services, what PiML Web Services does is enables mobile devices to communicate wirelessly back to manual logger. If that's the case, then IIS must already be properly installed and running on this computer. With SQL Server that has been previously installed, it's important to note that the user that you're running the installation under should have the rights to create databases in SQL Server. Also, SQL Server should have Windows authentication turned on. The installation kit I'll be using is Pi Manual Logger 2012. Here are the components that will be installed. It's verified that my prerequisites are available. Here are some notes that include instructions if you're upgrading manual logger. Also, if you're planning to use PiML Web Services. The path for PiML Windows. This is the manual logger installation path. This normally would go into the PiPC folder. If I already have a Pi installation on this box, then this is already defaulted for me. Here's my install feature selection list. First, database files. If I'm going to be using SQL Server on this box, I want this enabled. Next, client application. Again, this is actually putting the manual logger application on this box. So if this is going to be a station that an operator or configurer will use, I want to include this. Autosync utility. As is noted here, this lets me automatically sync the data between a dock device and the host server. So again, if I'm using this as a workstation for someone to enter manual logger data, I probably want auto-sync. Windows services. As is noted here, this is a Windows service that runs in background and enables the PiML database to keep in sync with Pi. It also enables caching and sending of future data. Also, as is noted here, this only needs to be installed in one place, presumably where the SQL Server database resides. Finally, there's the web services. This is what was mentioned earlier. This allows wireless data transfer to and from PiML mobile devices. I'm going to select all the options for now. Since I have the web services option selected, I'll have to choose my IIS website. I'll choose the default website. After this, the install of manual logger proceeds. Here's an additional note to please refer to the post-installation procedures in the guide. Now the installation is complete. Now for my post-install steps. The first thing I must do is attach the manual logger database to SQL Server. For this, I'm going to go into the directory where manual logger was installed and find the different SQL Server version templates. Again, I'm going to my PyPC directory. Then into PyML Windows. If I look, there's a folder here entitled Data. And then I see PyML Windows MDF files. These are my database files for different versions of SQL Server. I'm using 2008. So what I want to do first is copy these to a secure location. I'm going to create a new folder for this. I'll paste these into this folder. And also, I'm going to change the properties so that they are no longer read-only. The templates come shipped as read-only. Okay, now I'm ready to go into SQL Server and attach these to SQL Server. So I'll use SQL Server Management Studio for this. I'll log in using my Windows user. Now I need to do an attach. I'll go and browse to the location I just added the files to. And I'll choose my SQL Server specific manual logger database. From here I'll say OK. And I'll notice there's a new database listed named PyML Windows. This is all I need to do in SQL Server. My next step is simply to get into Manual Logger and test that I've successfully created the database, attached to it, and I'm able to log in. So I'm going to my PySystem menu, go into the Manual Logger group, and open Manual Logger. I could also go to Configuration Tools to test as well. These are the tools that I would use if I need to change the databases at some point. It is attached to SQL Server, now I need to log in. By default, Manual Logger ships with one user, PyML, with a password of PyML. So I say OK, Manual Logger is initiated. This shows me that I have a successful installation. As I see in the status bar across the bottom, my SQL Express instance is being used by PyML Windows. This also shows me the Py server that I've defaulted into, which is my default Py server. From here, I could go on and start to create tours or collect data. A second check that I might do is see that my PyML Windows service actually installed. So I'll go look at the services control panel. I'll scroll down to PyML Windows. I'll see that he is here and started. Again, this is the service that provides future and cached data, as well as syncing to Py. Finally, as I mentioned earlier, one of the other tests I could have done was brought up the configuration tool. So again, I'll go into the Py Manual Logger group just to show this. Come into Configuration Tools. Here I see my database. I can set up the connection, sync data. Also see my services. If I set up the connection, I see that it defaults in what I've already used, and I can do a test here. So this shows me I successfully connected to my PyML database in my local SQL server, which is SQL Express. And with that, we've shown that we have a successful PyML 2012 installation.